Welcome back to P block elements. Previous class we have discussed nitrogen and its derivatives of group 15th elements like dinitrogen, ammonia, nitric acid. Okay. Today we'll go for phosphorus and its derivatives. Before going phosphorus and its derivatives, what is the allotropic nature of phosphorus? Phosphorus, it is having so many allotropic natures, but mainly we are studying it is having a white phosphorus, red phosphorus, and black phosphorus. That is the allotropic nature of phosphorus. We will go for the types of phosphorus. The first one, it is white phosphorus. Second one is red phosphorus, and third one is black phosphorus. Okay, these are three types of allotropic in nature. White phosphorus, it is a waxy solid. Okay, the first one, the white phosphorus, it is a colorless waxy solid. Colorless waxy solid in nature. Okay, and the white phosphorus, just you exposed in air, okay, it is color is changed, the color is also called yellow phosphorus. Okay, yellow phosphorus is also called as white phosphorus. Okay, and white phosphorus is a poisoning in nature. This is a toxic or poisonous. Okay, toxic or poisonous. Next one, the fourth one, the white phosphorus is insoluble in water, but soluble in carbon disulfide, ether, organic solvent, etc. Okay, this is the solubility process. Okay, next one, the white phosphorus is dissolved in sodium hydroxide. Okay, white phosphorus is dissolved in sodium hydroxide. This is a P4. When the white phosphorus is dissolved in sodium hydroxide solution to form phosphine, one molecules of phosphine, one phosphine, remaining three phosphorus is there, plus three Na sodium hypophosphate, sodium hypophosphate. Okay, this is the solubility. Means phosphorus is soluble in sodium hydroxide solution. Okay, it is insoluble in water. To form, this is sodium hydroxide, means it is having a caustic soda. When your aluminium is dissolved in sodium hydroxide to form sodium aluminate, or zinc is dissolved in sodium hydroxide to form zinc aluminate, that is also one of the year also. The phosphorus is dissolved in sodium hydroxide to form phosphine and sodium hypophosphate. Okay, this is the one of the factor. Next one, the structure of phosphorus, white phosphorus, this is a bond angle, PPP bond angle is 60 degree, bond angle is 60 degree. Okay, and the white phosphorus which contain 4 phosphorus is there and 4 pair of electrons, and PP bond total, it is a number of here 6 PP bond is there, and here the 4 lone pair of electrons are non-bonding electrons, lone pair of electrons. This is the bond angle is 60 degree. Okay, 60 degree. This is poisonous in nature. It is a poisonous in nature. This is the properties of, it is a white phosphorus. Okay, this is the properties of white phosphorus. Coming to here, the red phosphorus. Okay, red phosphorus, the first one, when here the white phosphorus is heated with 573 Kelvin, white phosphorus is converted to red phosphorus. Listen here, lead phosphorus. The red phosphorus is a colorless crystalline solid. Colorless crystalline solid. This is a waxy solid. This is a soft in nature, soft. But when the temperature is increases, means it is having a odd or crystalline solid. Okay, this is the red phosphorus. Second one, the red phosphorus, when it is formed, that is a non-toxic, non-poisonous. Listen here, same, both are phosphorus, but it is allotrophic nature. This one is poisonous in nature. This is a non-poisonous. Okay, non-toxic. Okay, next one, the third one, the red phosphorus is insoluble both water as well as carbon disulfide. Insoluble in carbon disulfide as well as water. This is the third property. Next one, the phosphorus, the red phosphorus is a poor conductor. Red phosphorus is a poor conductor. Okay, poor conductor. And here the red phosphorus, the density of red phosphorus, density of red phosphorus 2.1. But here the density of white phosphorus 1.84, like sulfuric acid density. Okay, 1.84 it is, you can remember. This is the density of red phosphorus is 2.1. Next, the structure of white phosphorus, when it is a structure of white phosphorus, to form polymeric chain of structures, when it is having a polymeric chain, the white phosphorus, this is a phosphorus, okay, continues, one phosphorus chain is attached to another phosphorus chain, here also phosphorus. This is a polymeric chain of phosphorus, it's a red phosphorus. Okay, this is a n number of polymer chain. This is a polymeric chain of nature. This is only the one molecules P4. Here also, all it is having a phosphorus hybridization is sp3 hybridization. Next, coming to here, the phosphorus, here also sp3 hybridization, and phosphorus, each phosphorus which contain lone pair of electrons, this is the difference between white phosphorus and red phosphorus. Okay, when we are going for white phosphorus, here white phosphorus, white phosphorus is heated 573 Kelvin, you will get red phosphorus. This is the one of the important. Next, the white phosphorus is heated at 573 Kelvin under high pressure, means you are getting a black phosphorus. Or your red phosphorus is heated with the 800 Kelvin, directly aided at Kelvin, you will get a black phosphorus. But the black phosphorus, it is a metallic in nature. Metallic in nature. Going here, the strength is increases. The phosphorus, waxy solid, here crystalline, here the metallic nature. Metallic in nature. That is one of the important character. Metallic nature or metallic cluster. Metallic cluster. Okay. Next one. It is also insoluble in both carbon disulfide. This is metal, means it is also insoluble in both water as well as carbon disulfide. Okay. And it is also non-toxic. Okay. This is also non-toxic. One of the important factor I will forget. Listen here. But here the white phosphorus, the odor is important. The white phosphorus is odor. The next point is white phosphorus is the seventh point. Okay. Seventh point. The white phosphorus odor is garlic odor. Garlic odor. This is the red phosphorus is odorless. One of the important difference between white phosphorus and it is a colorless waxy solid and garlic odor. These are, it is having a crystalline solid odorless molecules. This is also odorless, non-toxic and odorless. Okay, odorless. Next one, it is a good conductor. Good conductor. Okay, the red black phosphorus is a good conductor. It is also polymeric chain of, it is also polymeric chain of in nature. That is having a polymeric chain of phosphorus, 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 phosphorus. That is phosphorus, phosphorus linkage is there. These are all it is having a difference between white phosphorus, red phosphorus and black phosphorus. White phosphorus is heated with 500 degree Kelvin. Under high pressure, you will get the black phosphorus. The density of this one, the density of black phosphorus is 2.69. Here 2.1, here 1.84. Density is going here, increasing in order. These are all it is having a allotrophic nature of phosphorus. Next, we will go for phosphorus and its derivatives. Okay. Phosphine and phosphorus trichloride and phosphorus pentachloride. Student, next we will go for phosphorus and its derivatives. Nitrogen derivatives, this is a phosphorus derivatives. Phosphorus derivatives is 3 molecules is there. First one is phosphine, phosphorus trichloride and phosphorus pentachloride. Okay. First we will go for the phosphorus. Phosphine, sorry, phosphine. The phosphine formula PH3, NH3 ammonia. This is a phosphine, PH3. Okay. The phosphine is a preparation of phosphine from phosphorus. Okay. And second one from calcium phosphine. Third one from calcium phosphate using different molecules. Fourth one from phosphonium iodide. Okay. The first one, phosphine is react with sodium hydroxide solution. Solution means it is a in water, okay, in water, to form one molecules of phosphine, remaining three phosphorus is there, three sodium hydroxide is there, and released three molecules of sodium hypophosphate. This is a phosphine. Here sodium hypo phosphate. phosphite, sodium hypophosphite. Next one, the calcium phosphate is react with water, 6 molecules of water. Here the phosphorus, how many phosphorus is there? 2 phosphorus is there. 2 phosphorus means you will get 2 molecules of phosphite. Water, water means HOH. How many molecules is there? 6. 6 molecules means 6H and 6OH is there. 6H is consumption here, 6H. Add 6 molecules of hydroxy, 6OH is there. 6OH means 3 molecules of calcium. You released 3 molecules of calcium hydroxide, 6OH group. Okay, you can balance the equation. Next here, again here calcium phosphate is react with acid, acidic media. Means hydrochloric acid. Here also how many phosphorus? 2 phosphorus. And chloride is 6 chloride. 2 molecules of here also. Here 6H is there. 6H and 2 phosphorus means we will release 1 molecule of phosphine. And 3 calcium and 6 chloride. You will release it is having 3 molecules of calcium chloride. Okay. Next one. Phosphonium iodide, when the phosphonium iodide is react with potash, aqueous potassium hydroxide, to release here potassium iodide, one hydrogen is attached to here, means water molecules, release the water molecules to form phosphine and potassium iodide water. Okay, this is the preparation of phosphine from different molecules. You will get here a preparation of phosphine, phosphine, phosphine and phosphine. So one of the important. Okay. Next, you will go for physical and chemical properties of phosphine. Next, properties of, properties means chemical and physical properties. Phosphine is a colorless gas. Okay. Phosphine is colorless gas, okay, with rotary fishy smell, okay, means it is having a rotor fishy odor, and here rotten fishy odor, and slightly soluble in water, okay, slightly soluble in water. This is the properties of phosphine. When the phosphine is a poisonous, highly poisonous in nature, phosphine is a highly poisonous, okay. It is a rotten fishy odor, means it is having a, the odor, it is having a rotten fishy odor, and it is highly poisonous in nature. When the phosphine is heated with water or decomposed, when the phosphine is decomposed, and release the hydrogen gas. Okay, this is the one of the important properties. Okay, next one, the chemical properties. When the chemical properties of phosphine, it is react with copper sulfate. Phosphine is react with copper sulfate. Okay, and mercury chloride. Okay, copper sulfate and mercury chloride means when the phosphine, 2 molecules of phosphine, okay, is react with copper sulfate or mercury chloride to form copper phosphide, copper phosphate, and released here how many hydrogen? 6 hydrogen, means 3SO4, and released the 3 molecules of H2SO4. Sulfuric acid is released. Simultaneously here, coming to here, the mercury chloride is react with phosphine. When the mercury chloride is react with phosphine to form here the mercury phosphide, Hg3P2. mercury phosphide and hydrochloric acid. Hydrochloric acid. This is the one of the important chemical properties. Last one, phosphine is react with hydrobromic acid or hydroiodic acid to form phosphonium iodide. Phosphonium bromide, phosphonium chloride. This is the one of the important properties of chemical properties of phosphine. React with copper sulfate, react with mercury chloride, react with hydrogen bromide. These are the chemical properties. This is a colorless gas and rotten fishy odor and slightly soluble in water, highly poisonous in nature. These are all dissolving physical and chemical properties. What is the uses of phosphine? Phosphine, it is a phosphorus, it is uses is mainly match stickers. And phosphine, it is used in one of the important in ohm signal, that is the ohm signal application means it is having a ohms signals in sea level, deep sea level. Something happened means we are using a calcium phosphide. It is important, it is used in ohm signals and it is having a smoke screen. This is one of the important application of phosphine. Okay, next we will go for another preparation and physical property and chemical property of phosphorus trichloride, one by one. Okay student, we are forget it is having a the geometry of phosphine or structure of phosphine. The phosphine, it is a pyramidal shape. The shape is it is having a pyramidal shape, but in ammonia trigonal pyramidal shape, but here pyramidal shape. The bond angle HPH, the bond angle it is having a 93 degree. In ammonia the bond angle is 107 degree, difference between phosphine and ammonia. But here the phosphine, the hybridization is sp3 hybridization. It is one of the important factor. Hybridization is sp3 and which contain lone pair of electrons is there, is phosphine. Okay, and is the phosphine is react with, okay, phosphine is react with water. Okay, phosphine is react with oxygen to form phosphorus. Here you will go for it is having two molecules, here also four molecules. Okay, when the phosphine is react with water to form here phosphorus trioxide P2O3. Okay, P2O3 R2PO3 means it is having a P2O3, one molecules. Here when the phosphine is react with oxygen to form P4O10. If the excess of phosphine, when the phosphine is react with, when the phosphine is react with heated at certain temperature to form here the phosphine and hydrogen gas is released. Here suppose we are taken here four molecules of phosphine means here six molecules of hydrogen. Okay, this is the important factor. Here also suppose we are taken here the four molecules of phosphine, P4, O means it is a suppose oxygen, we are taken here 12 hydrogen is there, 12 hydrogen means you are released the six molecules of water, six oxygen and 10 oxygen, total oxygen is required, total 16 oxygen means here using a 8 molecules of oxygen, means phosphine is oxidized to form is a phosphorus decoxide and here released 6 molecules of water. Okay, this is oxidized, this is oxidized to form phosphorus decoxide. Okay, phosphorus decoxide, when the phosphine it is heated certain temperature it released hydrogen gas. This is the one of the important factor of phosphine. Next we will go for phosphorus trichloride. Okay student, next we will go for phosphorus trichloride, preparation of phosphorus trichloride, the first preparation. When the phosphorus is react with, phosphorus is react with chlorine, limited quantity of chlorine, to form phosphorus trichloride. It's a neat reaction. Phosphorus is react with, chlorine, to form phosphorus trichloride. And we can also prepare, when the phosphorus trichloride, phosphorus is react with here thionyl chloride, and here taken the total molecules, means 8 molecules of thionyl chloride, here to form phosphorus trichloride, here total molecules is 16 is there, and released sulfur dioxide, total number of molecules is here sulfur dioxide and S2Cl2. Listen here, how many sulfur is there? 4 sulfur, 8 sulfur is there, here 4 molecules, oxygen, here 16 oxygen is there, here sulfur dioxide and sulfuryl chloride is a 2 molecules of sulfuryl chloride. Here the thionyl chloride, when the phosphorus is react with, this is a thionyl sulfonyl chloride, means here total number of chlorine is 16, here 12 plus 4, 16. This is the one of the important preparation of phosphorus trichloride from phosphor in presence of chlorine and thionyl chloride. Next, the properties of phosphorus, physical and chemical properties. When the physical properties of phosphorus trichloride is a gas, phosphorus trichloride, when it is having a phosphorus which trigonal shape similar to, pyramidal shape similar to ammonia, and which contain lone pair of electrons, or we can go for this is the structure of phosphorus trichloride is a this is a pyramidal shape and which contain lone pair of electrons, and the hybridization is sp3 hybridization. Why does the phosphorus trichloride to moisture exposed in moisture? Chemical properties. When the phosphorus trichloride is react with water, to form H3PO3. How many chloride is there? 3 chloride, and release the fumes. Which fumes? HCl fumes. This is a fumes. When it is a moisture is there, means why does phosphorus trichloride is moisture or fumes with moisture? When the phosphorus trichloride is with moisture, to release the phosphorus acid. This is a phosphorus acid. It released the hydrochloric acid. They will ask one more questions. These are all, it is having a complete reaction, means they will ask so many questions in 1 mark, 2 mark, 3 mark. complete the reaction, complete the reaction, okay. And phosphorus trichloride, here the phosphorus trichloride, it is used in organic synthesis, organic synthesis, hydroxy derivatives like alcohol and carboxylic acid, for example, I will take here ethanol C2H5OH, ethanol and ethanoic acid CH3COOH, CH3COOH, carboxylic acid, alcohol, OH is there means. When it is react with how many phosphorus trichloride, PCl3, here also phosphorus trichloride. How many chloride is there here? 3 chloride. 3 chloride means 3 molecules of HCl, 3H, okay. Here to form here the chloride means here 3 molecules of C2H5Cl. 3 molecules of C2H5Cl, ethyl chloride, or you will go for, it is also CH3Cl, 3 moles, CH3COCl, how many moles? 3 molecules of acetyl chloride, 3 molecules of acetyl chloride, and released 3H, 3O and 1P, 3H means H3 and 1P, and O3, this is a phosphorus acid, here also H3PO3, okay, this is a phosphorus acid, this is one of the important, is a phosphorus acid, okay. These are all, it is having a chemical properties of phosphorus trichloride, it is hydroxy compounds like alcohol and carboxylic acid, this is one of the important one. Phosphorus trichloride, it is a one of the uses in preparation of organic compounds, alloalkanes and alloarenes. This is one of the important fact. Next, we will go for phosphorus pentachloride. Okay, students. Next, we will go for last derivatives. Phosphorus pentachloride. When the phosphorus pentachloride, the first one, preparation of phosphorus pentachloride. When the phosphorus is react with excess of chlorine, okay, phosphorus is react with excess of chlorine. Limiting of chlorine means you will get phosphorus trichloride. If the phosphorus is react with excess of chlorine to form phosphorus pentachloride, this is the preparation of phosphorus pentachloride. Or you will go for the phosphorus is react with sulfuryl chloride. What is difference between sulfuryl and sulfonyl chloride? This is the sulfonyl chloride. Before we are using a phosphorus trichloride, using a thionyl chloride or sulfonyl chloride, But here sulfuryl chloride, okay. When the sulfuryl chloride, 10 molecules of sulfuryl chloride, to release here 20 Cl and 4 phosphorus, here the 4 molecules of phosphorus pentachloride and released sulfur dioxide. Okay, this is the second. This is the two method is a preparation of phosphorus pentachloride. Okay, coming to here, phosphorus pentachloride, physical properties of phosphorus pentachloride. Phosphorus pentachloride, both it is having a gases and liquid in nature. Here the phosphorus pentachloride structure, it is a trigonal bipyramidal. The structure, it is having a trigonal bipyramidal. Okay, this is the structure of phosphorus pentachloride. Here the bond length of phosphorus pentachloride, three bond, it is having a three bond PCL, it is having a equatorial in nature, and two bond, it is having a axial, but axial is more repulsion than equatorial. Axial PCL bond, PCL PCL bond is more repulsion with each other, and the bond length also, here the bond length also is more compared to the equatorial. PCL, it is having a bond length is 240 picometer. Coming to here, the PCL equatorial, it is having a 202 picometer, the bond length. Okay, here also the phosphorus pentachloride, the shape is trigonal by pyramidal shape, and it is equatorial as well as axial. Axial is more repulsion. Okay, in solid state what will happen, it is having an ionic form. Ionic form means here the phosphorus pentachloride in solid state, when it is having a crystalline nature, to form a two ionic character, suppose two phosphorus trichloride, means here the PCl 4 and PCl 6, positive and negative ion. Here the PCl 4, it is having a tetrahedral shape, and PCl 6 is octahedral, like a complex compound. Okay, in the cooling, when you go for it is having a cooling, it is having a crystal to form ionic in nature. Okay, that is, it is having a tetrahedral and octahedral shape. It is one of the important character. Coming to here, next one, the chemical properties of phosphorus. When the phosphorus pentachloride, chemical properties of phosphorus pentachloride, when the phosphorus pentachloride, it is a sublime or decomposes, okay, to form phosphorus trichloride and chlorine gas. Okay, when the phosphorus pentachloride is react with phosphorus pentachloride is react with one molecule of water to form phosphorus oxychloride, POCl3, how many chlorine is released? 2 chlorine and 2H, released hydrochloric acid. Here also, when the phosphorus trichloride is react with water to moisture, it is released HCl fumes, it will form. Here also, in case if the excess of phosphorus pentachloride, if it is react with excess of water, if you suppose three molecules of water, listen here, when the phosphorus pentachloride is react with water, but it is having a one molecules of water, means you will get it is having a phosphorus oxychloride. If you will get a three molecules of water to form phosphoric acid H3PO4, okay, H3PO4, okay, and released three molecules of hydrochloric acid. Here, how many hydrochloric acid is there here? Phosphorus pentachloride, it is react with three molecules of water, and here the three molecules of water means is a three molecules of HCl and H3PO4, and released one molecules of chlorine. Okay, one molecules of chlorine. Here the phosphorus or phosphoric acid maybe. Okay, this is the react with water. Okay, in coming to the organic synthesis means same, it is similar to phosphorus trichloride. When the phosphorus trichloride is react with alcohol C2H5OH, phosphorus pentachloride is react with ethyl alcohol and acetic acid. When the phosphorus pentachloride is react with alcohol, ethanol alcohol and ethanoic acid to form ethyl chloride. Here also ethyl chloride, ethyl chloride, okay, and phosphorus oxychloride and hydrochloric acid, okay. Next, if the acetic acid is react with phosphorus, means here CH3COCl and POCl3 and released hydrochloric acid. This is the haloalkanes and acetyl chloride when it is react with alcohol is react with phosphorus pentachloride to form this product. In case some of silver and tin is react with, here silver and tin react with, here it is having a silver and tin. Suppose here the silver is react with phosphorus pentachloride to form two molecules of silver chloride and phosphorus trichloride, another property. In case is a tin is react with phosphorus pentachloride, tin is react with phosphorus pentachloride to form stannic chloride. Stannic chloride means SnCl4. Stannic chloride. How many chloride is it? 10. 10 is 4 is consumed to release phosphorus trichloride. Means it is react with metal. React with metal like silver and tin. React with organic compounds like alcohol and carboxylic acid. React with moisture, means water. React with water. Just it is go for sublime or decomposition of PCl3, you will get a chlorine gas. These are all it is having a water, phosphorus trichloride, and out of preparation of phosphorus trichloride, physical properties and chemical properties of phosphorus trichloride. Next, we will go for oxo acids of phosphorus, okay, one by one. Okay, student. Next, we will go for oxo acids of phosphorus. Oxo acids of phosphorus means phosphorus trioxide, phosphorus pentoxide and phosphorus decoxide, This is the phosphorus structure, it is having a P4 model. When oxo acids of phosphorus means it is a PO double bond is there. PO double bond, it is containing hydroxy derivatives, means protonic acid is there, that is the oxo acids of phosphorus. Here, first we will go for oxo acids of phosphorus. First, you should remember one, means glucose, you know well, means you will write the all structures. Here also, you should know the phosphoric acid structure means, listen carefully, phosphoric acid structures, here phosphoric acid, okay. Pentavalency, when here oxygen is carbonyl, carbonic acid, sulfuric acid, okay, nitrous acid, phosphoric acid, phosphorus acid, phospho derivatives of acid. Here phosphorus double bond and which contain here OH, here also OH. Listen carefully. You should remember here the phosphorus and here also phosphorus. All compounds which containing, double bond O, okay. Same, okay. Here also P double bond O, P double bond O, P double bond O, all phosphorus is same. But here OH, 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 the structure is, H, how much is there? 1, 2, 3, H3, P 1, 2, 3, 4, HP 3, O 4. H3PO4, that is called as phosphoric acid. You should remember the name is phosphoric acid. Phosphoric acid. Okay, this is the structure of phosphoric acid. You know phosphoric acid structure well, means you can write all derivatives of oxo acids of phosphorus. What you should remember? You should remember is a phosphorus. Above double bond O and OH, OH, OH is a 3H, OH, OH, OH. Here is a phosphoric acid, OH, OH, OH. In case I will replace it one oxygen. Here also same OH, OH. And here OH oxygen should not write here. One oxygen is less. Okay. The hydrogen, how much is hydrogen? Three hydrogen is there. Here three hydrogen. H3PO 1, 2, 3. H3PO3. Okay. Here the name is phosphorus acid. Phosphorus acid. This one is phosphoric acid. Here phosphorus acid. This is the structure of phosphorus acid. Just should not write oxygen. One oxygen. Coming to here, the same number here also. When here the compound it is having oxygen is there. Here OH. Here also OH, OH is there. Here also should not write O. Here also should not write O. Remove O, O. Okay. If it is a phosphoric acid, one means it is a phosphorus acid. Two removal means it is having a hypophosphorus acid. This is having a formula. Formula means H3PO2. The name is hypophosphorus acid. Hypophosphorus acid. This is the hypophosphorus acid. Should remember. This is the structure of phosphoric acid, phosphorus acid, and hypophosphorus acid. Next, you should remember this is a 2 moiety. 2 moiety is there means, suppose I will write here the phosphorus, double bond O, okay, here double bond O, and here also double bond O, here OH, 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 here also OH, 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 okay. Here OH, 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 here also OH, OH, OH. Listen carefully. Same formula, phosphoric acid. But here removal of water. Removal H2O, removal of water. Okay, same structure, here also same structure. Removal of water. The bond here oxygen, H2O remove. When here H2O remove means that is called as pyrophosphoric acid. Removal, pyro means removal of water. This is having a formula H1, 2, 3, 4, H4, P2, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, O7. Okay, the name is pyrophosphoric acid. Okay, here also you should remember I will take 2 moiety here also, means here also removal of 2 what, 1 molecules of water, 2 molecules of hypophosphorus, removal of one water, that is called pyrophosphorus acid. Here the pyrophosphoric acid, inter-elimination of water between the two hypophosphoric, sorry, phosphoric, ortho, this is also called orthophosphoric acid. Orthophosphoric acid is a phosphorus acid, okay? Oxygen is not there. This is the structure of pyrophosphoric acid, okay? This one. Next one, you write N number of phosphoric acid. N number of phosphoric acid means, suppose I will write here N number of phosphoric acid, P, 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 okay, and double bond O, and the bond is here OH is there. When it is having a bond here OH and OH, inter-elimination of water molecules, here also OH, and here also inter-elimination of water molecules, and here also OH, and here also inter-elimination of water molecules. Here it is having N number of water molecules. Here it is having a polyphosphoric acid. This is the formula HPO3. How many moles? N moles. HPO3, it is having a N moles. Is called polyphosphoric acid. Polyphosphoric acid. This is a polyphosphoric acid. Listen here. Very, very important. Next one. You take, it is having how many moles? It is having N number of moles. N number of polyphosphoric acid. Okay, phosphoric acid. N number of phosphoric acid. This is a polyphosphoric acid. Metapolyphosphoric acid. Sometimes they will ask metapolyphosphoric acid. Next, coming to here, metacyclophosphoric acid. Metacyclophosphoric acid means, listen here, phosphorus, okay, and here the bond is double bond O, okay, and how many OH? One OH here, and another OH here, OH, okay, and here also another OH. Here also the bond here, okay, here bond O and here OH, O, okay, and here also oxygen and here also OH and here also O. Listen carefully. Suppose here OH is there, just imagine, here also OH is there. And I will write here also, when it is a bond for OH and OH, inter-elimination of water, here removal of one water. And here also the bond is there. Here also one oxygen is there. Okay. And phosphorus, here also one phosphorus. Double bond. O, here OH, okay, and how many OH? Double bond, one OH, here also one OH, inter-elimination of water, here also one OH, inter-elimination of water. This is a cyclic structure. The formula is HPO3, HPO3. How many moles? 3 moles. Here, the one molecules of HPO3, one another molecules of H3O3, another molecules of H3O3. This is how many moles? 3 moles. The name is, this is the name is cyclophosphorous acid. Cyclophosphoric. Okay, na? Cyclophosphoric. Cyclophosphoric acid. This is the cyclophosphoric acid. Okay. These are all it is having. They will ask one more question. Write the phosphoric acid. You should remember phosphoric means here phosphorus double bond O, OH, OH, OH. This is a phosphorus. If should not write oxygen means phosphorus. Should not write another oxygen means hypophosphorus. You have to write the two molecules of phosphoric acid, inter-elimination of water, that is called pyrophosphoric acid. And if you add n number of phosphoric acid, that is called as polyphosphoric acid. You take it is having three molecules of phosphoric acid, inter-elimination of three molecules of water, that is called cyclophosphoric acid. Okay, these are all it is having oxo acids of phosphorus, oxo acids of phosphorus. Listen here, how many bond formation is there? This is having a OH, OH, OH. How many bond is there? 3 OH bond is there. This is a tribasic. Okay. This is a, the name is, it is having a tribasic. Tribasic. Okay. This is a dibasic behavior. Dibasic. And this one is monobasic. Monobasic. Okay. And here tetrabasic. Okay. Pyrophosphoric acid, it is having a tetrabasic basicity or hydroxy compounds. Okay, this is the important character. This is a pyrophosphoric acid. Suppose if you take it is having a two molecules means per phosphoric acid means should not write oxygen. Listen here, if it is heated means, suppose I will write here phosphorus, okay, and phosphorus, okay, double bond O, and here also directly, oxygen, OH. Suppose here oxygen is removing means that is having a per phosphoric acid, per oxy. This is having a per. This is a per pyrophosphoric acid. Here per phosphoric acid. Per phosphoric acid. The formula 1, 2, 3, 4, H4P2O6 means it is a per phosphoric acid. H4P2O7 means pyrophosphoric acid. Why they are called pyro? Per means peroxy. Okay, that is having a peroxy. Okay, these are all it is having a oxo acids of phosphorus. Let us go for how many pH bond, PO bond, P double bond, O bond is there. This is the different character of oxo acids of phosphorus. Next we will go for, this is a monobasic, tribasic, tetrabasic. This is how many? 1, 2, 3, tribasic. This is a tribasic. Okay, this is a monopolybasic character. Okay, these are all it is having oxo acids of phosphorus. Listen, student, in entrance examination they will ask how many P double bond O in phosphoric acid. Here P double bond O, how many P double bond O? In all phosphoric acid, it is a phosphoric acid, one P double bond O. And how many POH bond? POH, POH, POH. How many POH bond? 3 POH bond. Okay. PH bond is not there. Okay. This is having a tribasic. This is a tribasic. Or it is having a three basic behavior. Next year also, P double bond O, P double bond O, how many bond is there? One. Okay. How many POH bond? POH bond. How many POH bond? POH, POH bond. Two POH bond. And how many PH bond is there? One PH bond. Okay. This is the number of PH and PO bond. Next one coming to F. How many P double bond O? Here. P double bond O. How many P double bond O? One. P double bond O, one. POH bond. POH bond also one. Where IO phosphorus, POH bond is one. Next, PH bond is two. Okay, PH bond is two. This is the one of the important. P double bond O, one. POH bond is one. PH bond is two. This is a monobasic. One hydroxy means monobasic. This is a dibasic. This is a dibasic. This is a tribasic. Next one, coming to here. Here the P double bond O, how many P double bond O is there? Two. P double bond O, P double bond O, two. Where pyrophosphoric acid? Pyrophosphoric acid. Next one, POH bond. POH, one OH, one OH, one OH, one. Total POH bond is four. Okay, POH bond. POP bond, POP bond also one. POP bond. PH bond is not there. Okay, this is the one, POP bond. Next, here sp3, sp2 hybridization. This is the sp2 hybridization, sp2 hybridization, sp3 hybridization. Double bond is there, means sp2 and sp3. Here also, this is a 1 2 3 4. How many hydroxy? 4 hydroxy, means it is having a tetrabasic behavior. Next, here coming to here, how many POH bond is there? POH bond. 1, 2, 3. Tribasic. PH bond, how many PH bond? PH bond not there, PH bond. P double bond O. P double bond O, how many P double bond O? 3 P double bond O, 3. Okay. Next, P double bond O, POP, POP, POP. POP character, how much is there? POP is 3. Okay, POP is 3. This is a 1, 2, 3. Tribasic. This is also tribasic behavior. Tribasic. Here also POH, 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 4 POH bond and P double bond O2. Okay, PP bond is there. POP not bond is there. This is PP bond. This is also N number of hydroxy derivatives. These are all it is having a oxo acids of phosphorus. Sometimes they will ask entrance examination, basic behavior and PP bond, PH bond, PO double bond O and POH bond. Okay. Next we will go for oxo acids of phosphorus pentoxide, phosphorus trioxide. We will go for one by one. Next we will go for oxides of phosphorus. When the phosphorus is react with oxygen, phosphorus is react with oxygen to form phosphorus trioxide P2O3 and phosphorus pentoxide. Okay, suppose here the three molecules of oxygen, means suppose it is having six molecules of oxygen, here the 10 molecules of oxygen to form phosphorus trioxide and phosphorus pentoxide. You should remember here the P4, okay, P4 is a phosphorus, phosphorus monoxide, phosphorus dioxide, phosphorus trioxide, phosphorus tetroxide, phosphorus pentoxide, okay. Next one, phosphorus oxoxide, simultaneously heptoxide,
octoxide, non-oxide, phosphorus decoxide. Listen here. Here, P2O3, this is a P2O3, and P2O5, this is very, very important. In the structure of phosphorus, what will happen? Structure of phosphorus, this is a phosphorus. P4, the bond length is 60 degree, this is a bond length. When here the white phosphorus, when it is oxygen, is one oxygen means, suppose white phosphorus, here when white phosphorus is react with one oxygen, this is a, the bond length increases. Compared to the PP bond, POP bond, this is a P4O, phosphorus monoxide, which contain how many lone pair of electrons? How many lone pair of electrons? Two lone pair of electrons. Simultaneously, P4O2 means here also one oxygen, and P4O3 here also one oxygen, here also one oxygen, and here also one oxygen, here also one oxygen. P4O6 means here all compounds is containing here phosphorus. Listen, here oxygen is there, here oxygen it will form here, oxygen is there, P4, and here the same structure we can write, we will go for here also the phosphorus, O, and here also O. Means here the phosphorus, okay, this is a bond, okay, this is a bond. When here attached here one oxygen, here attached one oxygen, two oxygen, three oxygen, four oxygen, and five oxygen, six oxygen. Total six oxygen, means this is the structure of P4O6 or P2O3. In P2O3 or P4O6, how many lone pair of electrons? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. How many oxygen is there into 2? How many here? 12 lone pair of electrons. And each phosphorus also which contain one lone pair. And phosphorus also 4 lone pair. Total how much? 16 lone pair of electrons is there. They will ask entrance examination. Number of lone pair of electrons in phosphorus trioxide. In only the phosphorus, coming to the only phosphorus means here, only phosphorus, how many lone pair of electrons? 1, 2, 3, 4. 4 lone pair of electrons. When it is oxygen is 1 enter, means it is having 4 plus 1, 4 plus 2, 6. Again to 1 oxygen which contain 2 lone pair of electrons. According to here, this is having a P2O4. Sometimes they will ask, it is having a hybridization. This is also all it is having a sp3 hybridization. Does not form sp2 hybridization. Double bond is not there. All it is having is sp3 hybridization. How many POP bond is there? POP bond, how many POP bond is there? 6 POP bond is there. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 6 POP bond. Okay? 6 POP bond is there. This is all dissolving hybridization is sp3 hybridization. Next, coming to here, the one oxoacid means it is having a one is a P4O7 enter means P4O7. Listen here, phosphorus. Okay, all bond it is having a oxygen bond. Oxygen, and also here one oxygen, here also one oxygen. This is having a P4O6. If the P4O7 means here one double bond O it will form. This is having a P4O7. Here one sp2 hybridization is there. One sp2 hybridization, remaining are all sp3 hybridization. Lone pair of electrons also here, 1, 2, 3, 4. A phosphorus does not contain lone pair of electrons because of pentavalency. Here the phosphorus already is having a, which contain lone pair of electrons. All are having lone pair of electrons. But here the phosphorus is 1, 2, 3, 4. Three phosphorus which contain lone pair of electrons, lone pair electrons, lone pair electrons. But one phosphorus does not contain lone pair of electrons. It is a pentavalency. These are all trivalency. Okay, if you go for another double bond O, means here also the phosphorus which contain double bond O. This is also phosphorus which contain double bond O. Here also the phosphorus which contain double bond O. The structure is P4O10 or P2O5 dimeric formation. When association of P2O5 into 2 twice P4O10. Here 1, 2, 3, 4. 4 PO bond is there. 4 PO bond. This is a which hybridization? Yes, the phosphorus is sp2 hybridization. Remaining is there. All phosphorus it is having sp2 hybridization. And how many POP bond is there? How many POP bond? Here the 6 POP bond is there. Okay, 6 POP bond. PP bond, POP bond. This is a PP bond, PP bond. And this is a POP bond. This is the structure of phosphorus pentoxide. This is the structure of phosphorus pentoxide. In entrance examination only they will ask phosphorus pentoxide. This one is phosphorus trioxide. Phosphorus trioxide. It is a dimeric formation, means phosphorus hexoxide. This is a phosphorus decoxide. These are all dissolving oxoacids of phosphorus or oxides of phosphorus, not oxo, oxides of phosphorus. They will, how many lone pair of electrons it will form? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 6 oxygen, 7, 8, 9, 10. Okay, total number of oxygen 10 is there. 10 oxygen which contain, it is a 20 lone pair of electrons. Phosphorus does not contain lone pair of electrons. How many sp2 hybridization, how many sp3 hybridization is there? They will ask, it is having sp3 hybridization. Okay, these are all, it is having important factor of oxides of phosphorus. They will ask entrance examination, it is important factor. Okay, next we will go for group 16 elements.